start a history, yes, history series of videos. Why did I feel the need to do that? Because basically, I don't know a lot about history. I used to like history in school, but how much I actually took in is very debatable. Because it was straight off my head. Too busy thinking about football and girls. So I figured I would do a series of videos on different historical events throughout our lives, or in not our lives, way, way back in previous lives. So that's the idea here, guys, I'm way back there. But this is just a taster, okay, of what to expect, because I've got some really good subjects to talk about. I'm watching documentaries, taking notes, I'm finding articles. I'm really looking forward to doing this series of videos. But I want to give you a rough idea of what to expect from this series, okay? So this here is a article on boredomtherapy.com. And this is 27 historical facts, weird ones that you'd never have thought of before, that you might, like, you never know, they might be useful. Maybe you'll need them in a, maybe I need them in a pub quiz one day, or a history exam. So let's get straight into this, guys. Right, random facts. Albert Einstein, this is number one, could have been president of Israel when it was formed, but he declined. So basically, I'm guessing Israel came along, all right there, Albert. Not Dumbledore, not Albert's Dumbledore, but Albert. We've heard you're quite intelligent. We would like an intelligent person to be the president of our country. We just formed it, yeah, last week. Put the rights to it. Now it's it. We've called it Israel. Do you want to be the president? He's like, yeah. It's a bit difficult at the minute. I'm kind of like, you know, discovering the whether or not things go up in the air and if things can stay down, and the difference between water and this and all this other crap that I don't understand. And I would do it, but I'm just a bit busy. If you, I could maybe fit you in a couple of weekends from now. I'm sure I've got a spare weekend free at some point, and we could talk about it. But you'd have to buy me a banana. I love a banana when I talk about presidential and prime minister roles. So if you give me a banana and a strawberry milkshake, we can discuss the role. Fact two. Before dentures were invented, teeth were pulled from the mouths of dead soldiers to use as prosthetics. Imagine that. Oh crap, I got a sore tooth. I got to Pete down the road, he's a dentist or something or other. Alright, Pete, I got a sore tooth. What can you do about it? Wait there. I've got a bag of teeth here. I had them delivered last week from the soldiers that died. Oh great, yeah, brilliant. Here you go. Stick that in there. Wow, Pete, there's a bit of chicken in this tooth still. Ooh, that'll do for me lunch. That'd be disgusting, wouldn't it? Because I bet they weren't clean first. Number three. Roman Emperor. Oh, crap. No, his name was not. Oh, crap. I've just clicked off the page. Roman Emperor Gaius, also known as Caligula. Caligula. That's a cool word, isn't it? Caligula made one of his favourite horses a senator. Imagine the situation. Right, we want to get this bill passed, okay? The only way to get this passed, that all people have to wear hats on a Sunday. It's Sunday, I'm wearing my hat. Okay, the only way this is going to work is if we get a nay from all the senators. Who says nay? And then literally nobody says it, but then the horse goes, nay. So the horse agrees. Nobody else does, because they don't understand how to say nay. Number four. There's a giant mushroom in Oregon's Malheur National Forest with a root system that covers over 2,200 acres, making it the largest living organism in the world. This mushroom is flipping huge. Check it out. I don't know where, just type it in. Like Oregon's giant mushroom or something. This is absolutely ginormous. He looks like quite a fun guy, to be honest. Number five. living cat into a foul, really. Just pop down to Argos and buy one. Number 6. Heroin was once a perfectly acceptable medicine prescribed by doctors for everything from coughs to headaches. It's actually a picture of it here. A little bottle saying heroin with like a brand on there and everything. How crazy is that these days? I mean, imagine if that was the situation these days. You'd have all the drug addicts running down the doctors. Oh, doctor, I've got sore throat. All right, here, take your heroin. Oh, cheers, mate. Happy days. Sorry, didn't you just have a sore throat?
Mike still. No, there's no Mike. What happened to Mike?
delicious meat. Joseph, Joe for short, or Starling if you want to call me by my real name. Number 10, Chinese women used to painfully bind their feet to make them appear small and more feminine. There's actually a picture, that's nasty. I ain't got funny to say about that. Other than my missus has really small feet, and I reckon if she could, she'd do something that'd make her feet bigger, not smaller. I mean, Chinese women must have big, big feet back then. Number 11. The shortest war in history was the Anglo-Zanzibar War. It lasted just 38 minutes. Literally, they all got there. They're like, what? Is there no tea? No coffee? We don't even get a fry up. They want us to kill each other and there's no breakfast at the end of it, or even before. What kind of war is this? I want my breakfast. I need a good pot of tea on the table, a cup breakfast, and even then, I need a good couple hours rest afterwards to let digest. They want us to kick the crap out of each other for weeks, sorry, months, years, and they're not even giving us a brekkie. Sod this, let's go out and watch the football. That's how it went down, trust me. Number 12. Former North Korean dictator Kim Jong-il was said to be a great lover of music and composed 6 operas while he was in office. I bet he bloody did. He's like, dance, monkey boy, dance. Everyone's like, I'll dance, I'll do the bloody river dance if it keeps you from killing me. Please don't set anybody bombs off my house tonight. Everyone would be scared stiff. They'd have happily done an opera if they couldn't bloody sing. There was a documentary, a Vice documentary, on North Korea. It's so crazy over there. Like, literally, they'd go into a restaurant and there'd be no one in the restaurant, but it was all set up as though people had been in the restaurant and eaten, and then they were taking plates away and covering them back up with cling film and making out like, yeah, we're just going to get rid of this food now because somebody just left and left this food. They hadn't left at all. No one had been in there. Nobody came in there whilst these documentary people were there, and the food would be cut back over and took back and brought back out for the next imaginary people. Absolute nutty, like proper potty people, because of the dictatorship over there. Number 13, the Leaning Tower of Pisa was actually never straight to begin with. The foundation began to sink when they started on the second floor. Imagine that. Imagine that a lot. But just think about that one. Right, we have this big bloody tower to make. John, what the hell's happened? We're only on the second floor and already it's bending. Well, flipping it, Dave. What do you want me to do about it? Do you really want to start again on the first floor? We've got like another 50 to do yet. Nah, sod it. Just carry on, John. Just do what you gotta do. Just don't let it lean too much. Right, we'll make it out like it's a little quirky gimmick. We'll name it the Leaning Tower. Why not? It's already leaning anyway. Number 14. Ronald Reagan is best known for being president and acting in numerous films, but he was also a prolific lifeguard who saved 77 people from drowning. Wow, that's only slightly less than Donald Trump has been ordered to kill or to die in the last couple of years. 15. Researchers believe that the famous Guanajuato, I think that's right, might not be, mummies, terrible expressions are the result of the victims being buried alive. So there's a picture of this person like, yeah, they don't look like they died comfortably. Let's just say that. They look like maybe, like the celebrities look on I'm a Celebrity, when they get the rats put in them boxes like, if you put a rat in a box of me, just one rat, I would scream like I don't know what. You would never have heard a scream like it. Do there, everybody. Right, we've changed this video a little bit, this history video. We've gone from 27 facts to 19 because some of them be a little bit crap. And the audio cut out the other day when I recorded it, so I'm adding this bit on to the video. Fact 16. Before alarm clocks, there were people who were hired as knockers up. No, not blokes who got women knocked up. No, they were hired to shoot dry peas. slept through the alarm clock. She said for three, slept through. Said for four, slept through. So I'm there like, and then each time, I mean, much effort if she's a really deep sleeper. Pat, you gotta be at work at six. Get up, you lazy cow. Pat can't be woken. Or if the window is open and the pee hits the window, bounces up inside, bounces off the window ledge, lands in Pat's throat. You ain't waking Pat up anymore. But it's much not being your job. So, what did you do for your last employment? I blew peas at windows. I'd go around going, but every once in a while I'd suck them backwards and I'd end up choking a little bit. That's why I've got this really horsey voice. But yeah, what a ridiculous job. I mean, why not? It'd be a lot easier, surely, to get a ladder. Walk down the street with your ladder. Prop it up against the window. Climb the ladder. Pat. Oh, Pat. It's time to wake up, love. Yeah, you got your 6 o'clock shift starting in 2 hours. Pat's like, oh, thank you. At least I didn't charge there for a dry pee this day, today. Number 17. Rasputin survived being poisoned, shot and stabbed numerous times before drowning in the Volga River. So what happened here, guys? I'll tell you what happened. They tried everything to get rid of Rasputin. Didn't work. Then Dave come down. Knock, knock, knock. Ras is like, what's up, Dave? How can I help? Oh, sorry to bother you, Ras. But Polly the sheep. Yeah, you know my sheep who I keep in the garden. Yeah, I seen her walking out into the river. I tried to stop her. She wouldn't listen. Ras is like, no worries, Dave. Let me get my waders on. Oh, bloody sirens. Hang on. Sod it if you hear it. He's like, whereabouts, Dave? Just out there in the river. I'll tell you what's a good idea, Ras, okay? So she can float back when you get to her. Take this big old brick, this huge brick, tie it round your ankles. Now walk out into the river. Now a little bit further, Ras. When you get there, give her the brick and she'll float back to the side and I'll have Polly the sheep back. Ras is like, oh, brilliant. Yeah, Rasputin's like, yeah, I'm a hero. I can be shot, stabbed, poisoned. Nothing can hurt me. I'll go out in the river. I can't see her, Dave. I can't see her, Dave. A bit further, Ras. A little bit further. But Dave, he's a bit deep over here. He's a little bit deep in the middle. He's okay, Ras. I promise nothing bad can happen. Just a little bit further. Ras is like, all right then, Dave. But I'm getting a bit wet here. It's up to me bloody waistline. Me pants are getting wet. Me undercrackers are soaking. I'm going to end up with fish in my pants. Just a little bit further, Ras. Okay. There are steps of a step further. Straight under. Rasputin was never seen again. And there was no pog of the sheep in the river. Dave killed Ras. Number 18. The word hooker as a term for prostitute originated with Civil War General Joseph Hooker, who brought prostitutes along on campaigns for his men. So you remember that 38-minute war I told you about before? That would not happen. They're all there, all these soldiers. Like, Christ, they want us to come out here in the middle of bloody winter and shoot each other, chase each other down, kill each other, whilst they sit at home eating their bloody warm meals. Seems a bit shit, doesn't it, really? Should we just pack up? Then General Hooker turns up. Lads, I've got plenty of women for all of you. Oh, happy days. Wait, who do you want dead first? Him or him? Can I have two women if I kill two men? Yes, you can have four women if you kill four. And so on and so on. Happy days. You, and you. Stand there, I'm about to shoot you in the head because I've got five women waiting for me. That's all he had to do to keep the blokes happy, was bring along some prostitutes. And then you would not have had that 38-minute war where they all packed up and buggered off for their Sunday lunch. Number 19. During the Great Depression, that was a time when everyone was just depressed. God, it's boring, isn't it? Let's take some antidepressants. People often made clothes out of potato sacks. Seeing this, distributors made them more colourful to help people remain at least somewhat fashionable. So the sack of spuds. I'll walk down that. Yeah. I can walk. Then I come back. Oh, God, my back. The next day, I can hardly stand up. 25 kilos on your back from there to there. Seems a long way when you're doing it. So, if they made their sacks more colourful, at least when I got back here, I put, hey, look at me. I've got a bad back, but at least I got a purple t-shirt out of it. Yeah, it looks like a potato sack, but it's purple. Happy days. I'd be a lot happier and a lot more willing to carry those potato sacks if they were more colourful, wouldn't you? I bet you would. That's it, guys. That was your taste of our history series when we actually